Hey internet, so if you watch my monthly vlogs, you will know that I went to go see a psychic as a birthday present for my friend Tayla. I videoed us going down to Brisbane and going and like the inside of this place, but I didn't video anything that was actually said in the psychic reading, or I didn't really tell you anything that happened because I wanted to save it for this video. I just want to start off by saying I have always been really interested in this kind of thing, like horoscopes, tarot cards, some kind of guidance from something. I also have always felt very lost. I always kind of have been a massive soul searcher, like needing guidance wherever I can get it, and always wondering like if I'm on the right path or if I'm doing the right thing, if there's kind of a plan for everyone, etc., etc. My friend Tayla and her mum have read my tarot cards a few times, and they've always kind of been so relevant. And Tayla had been to see this guy twice before, I think it was. So I've always really wanted to go. Was so interested in something, like to see what they'd say and, you know, it'd just be cool. So yeah, she got it for me as a birthday present, which I was really excited about. And every time I'd had my cards read before, I've always asked about career. Like you kind of shuffle them yourself and then they do the cards and like read from your aura, if that makes sense. But you kind of have to think of what you want to know as you're shuffling. You can ask it a question, you can just think about something. And yeah, I always ask about career. Career has always been my focus because it's one of the biggest things that I stress about in life. Since I was in high school, I've always stressed about it. And to be honest, like the last 2 years of my life have been very career focused and not at all romantic focused. I've just really not cared about romance or love and all that stuff because I had a pretty rough time in my last relationship that I just didn't really, I kind of wanted a break and I wanted a lot of me time. So that's why I've always focused on career and on things like that. But this time I totally was just like, you know what? I really want to know about love. I want to know if I'm gonna eventually meet someone or if I'm literally just gonna be forever alone, because I mean, without going too far into it, I guess I haven't exactly tried any kind of romances in the last 2 years or whatever, and I've been very shut off from that. So I just want to know if something's gonna happen. So I kind of went in with that mindset. Also, I just want to say I am a bit of a skeptic on things. I have a very reasonable, logical mind, but I also have a bigger part that is very like, it's an optimistic, wants to believe the good stuff, wants to believe all this stuff side, if that makes sense. So, you know, a lot of the things that he says in this reading is very vague. Well, some of it is. And some of it, you know, people always say they say things that can relate to everyone, like horoscopes. Personally, I don't think it's doing any harm if I'm just taking it as like a positive thing. I'm not believing it 100%. I'm not going to be devastated if these things don't come true or whatever. If you kind of take it lightheartedly and then see what happens, then I don't think it's such a bad thing. I basically voice recorded the whole thing. And then I took notes on it, listening back to the voice recording so that I could make this video and so that I could tell my friends and stuff what was said without missing any critical information. So I'm just gonna tell you exactly what he said, how I felt about it, and how it related to me. So first of all, he reads my aura and he sees colors and symbols. So the colors he sees are royal blue, violet, orange, and canary yellow. He said royal blue is learning and absorbing new information. And obviously I'm at uni, so that related. He said that it was very clear, a very clear color. And if it's murky, it means that you struggle to absorb it. But mine was clear, so it means I absorb it really easily. He said violet was soul searching, and it's kind of like you're always looking deeper into where you are, where you should be, kind of questioning like what you can do to make yourself happier. And that is a huge thing for me. Like, I am always that person who stresses, like, am I in the right place? Am I on the right path? What can I do? Like, where is my right place in the world? Kind of thing. And I know that's, like, probably everyone does that, but that hit home a little bit. So I was like, okay. He said, orange is work, money, and career, which obviously is a big part of my life at the moment. And everyone. So, I don't know. And then with the canary yellow, this is an interesting one. He said, it's not just a color, it's me driving a canary yellow bulldozer. And I was like, righto, that's really random. But apparently canary yellow is a really good headspace color. So he said, mentally I'm feeling really content and I'm driving the bulldozer, and it might be like areas around me right now that I feel in my life could be better. So I'm kind of like clearing a path, knocking those down to like try and get better things, if that makes sense. Which again is interesting because I'm on this whole like self-help journey. So maybe. He said, any challenges or blocks you felt you've had, you're moving past them. Bulldozers are also a sense of control, gives direction, a sense of achievement and progress. He said, it's a very happy symbol to see around you. It means things are resolving in case I've been feeling a little bit stuck. Weird. He also saw a love heart with a magnifying glass, which at first I thought was kind of like looking for love. But he was explaining it more like examining and really like judging someone in the love aspect. So he said like, there might be something coming in for me and I'm gonna be really like, am I making the right decision here? I'm really gonna be judging, do they have what I'm looking for? And it's gonna be like they're auditioning for me. So I was like, okay. He also saw an aeroplane, something to do with travel's gonna come up, like that's a big part of who I am, which it is. He said he saw some contracts, like I don't know if it was like a lease contract or a new job contract or some kind of paperwork. And then lastly he saw a bathtub filling itself up and overflowing. And he said like, am I a water sign? I said, yes, I'm a Cancer. He said, water signs are emotional. So the bathtub filling up kind of means maybe I've been really emotionally flat lately or low, and I'm coming into a cycle where I'm gonna be more happy and settled with myself. He said, I need to nurture myself. I've been busy worrying about everyone else. I need to come into me time where I need to focus on my emotions and I need to be emotionally uplifting myself. So I guess that's kind of true. I'm an emotions person, and when people need my emotional support, I give it 110% to my friends and family. Not so much to randoms, but you know. So then he kind of did the card reading and I guess he relates it to the aura. So first of all, he said, I'm watching my budget, keeping an eye on my expenses. It's not that I'm desperate. I'm just kind of watching what I have, but there's a change coming through that's going to bring a new cycle around me. I'm going to get some guidance and it's going to take me into a bit of a crossroads, which is interesting. Like when I kind of heard that, I was like, oh yeah, I'm trying to be careful with money because I'm at uni. I'm not getting as many shifts as I'd like because I'm at uni and I can't. And yeah, I guess I was just stressing a bit. But recently I won a scholarship, which is essentially like the uni gives me money every fortnight to just support me financially. And it was really unexpected. So now looking back, I'm like, oh, that's so weird. So anyway, interesting. There's someone new coming in that I don't know yet. It could be a water sign. It's definitely like a romantic relationship. They're gonna be a brand new person. And this is weird, okay. He really emphasized, I had the card of death, which is scary to look at and see on your thing. Like you're like, oh God. But it's actually a pretty good card. And it kind of means, he said in this context, it means brand new. So it's, he kept emphasizing, it's not someone from the past. It's not someone from the past. It's someone you've never met, someone brand new, which interestingly, someone from the past has kind of popped up. And I just think like the fact he kept emphasizing it, it's almost like he knew that was going to happen. And maybe I would think like, oh, he said there was going to be some romance. Is it this person again? So he's kind of like, yeah, nailed into me. Like, it's not anyone from the past. It's not. It's someone brand new you haven't met yet. So I'm like, okay, okay. And he said, there's a fate and destiny card. So fate and destiny are looking after it for me. It's all about timing. Fate is gonna set this person up for me to meet. And this is another interesting part. I always say to my friends, I don't wanna meet someone on Tinder. I don't wanna meet someone online. Not that there's anything wrong with it, but I'm just such a hopeless romantic that my kind of ideal situation would be meeting someone naturally and it to be, yeah, like fate. So I have such a big thing about that. And I kid you not, a few days before I went to this psychic reading, I literally told my friend this like in great detail, how like I was stressing, like, is it even possible to meet someone through destiny or fate these days in like the natural way. So anyway, just interesting that he said, you're not gonna meet this person on Tinder, online, etc. It's fate lining them up for you. He said there's a social card which indicates we might meet at a social event, maybe a wedding, maybe something casual like a barbecue. We're gonna really click, we're gonna really get along. He's gonna know some of my friends, and as soon as I meet him, I'm gonna think like, damn, he's hot, but I'm gonna friend zone him, which we'll get to later. But yeah, we're gonna really click at this social event and then we're gonna keep bumping into each other. We'll get back to that. He said, my neck, shoulders and back are really stiff and sore and I have lots of knots, which, oh my God, again, I literally at the gym the other night, I got a huge knot in my shoulder and I had to go out of PT because it was fucked. So that's so weird. It's like reading back, things keep happening and I'm like, oh, that's so weird. That's what he said. Anyway, sorry, I keep doing that. He said, I'm gonna fly through uni. I underestimate myself. I'm hard on myself and I stress myself out so much, but I don't need to because it's all gonna be fine. I'm gonna fly through it and do really well. So that's nice to hear. He said, I'm also doing some part-time work, but I need to stop stressing about whether it's like where I should be and stuff because it's just money right now. That's why I'm there. He said that there's many levels of this guy coming through. Maybe I see him at uni and where I work and I just keep bumping into him like he said. He said it's like he's not aware that I work there or that I'm there, but I just kind of see him and think like, oh my God, there's that guy again. But yeah, he said it's gonna start as a friendship. I'll be attracted to him, but I won't wanna rush into things. There's a card that was sensitivity of emotions. You'd be very scared to start a relationship as you may have experiences that haven't been that great in the past. So when you start getting towards that, you get some flashbacks and hesitate to continue. You stress like it will be like the past, and then you kind of make excuses like not having time for them with uni and hard to fit in and balance. Which is so me, like, I am, like, I can just imagine myself being like, oh God, relationship again, like, no, and freaking out about it, but it was just weird that he said that, like, oh, again, I don't know, whatever. But he basically said, don't get in your own head, let it naturally happen, let him prove a friendship to you, let yourself kind of study him, let him audition for you, see that he's not a sleazebag, he can make you laugh, he can connect with you and is patient, and he's not going to control my time because of uni and work. He's going to be understanding that you're busy, but happy for you to just fit him in where you can. And he's just going to be really good at respecting where I'm at, which obviously sounds amazing and ideal. So hopefully that's true. He said, I'm going to be putting this guy through the hoops, which isn't surprising, honestly. He said, it's going to be this year coming into the summer months. And this person's going to stand out to me more than others do. He said he didn't really feel like I'm looking for someone as such, and some days I think like, oh yeah, a relationship would be nice, but other days I'm like, oh, I can't be bothered, like I couldn't fit that into my schedule, which is so true. He said there's gonna be some more decisions with study, like fine-tuning areas, and I'm gonna come to a crossroads for decisions, but apparently it's gonna be like headlights on a dark road. It will light up when I need to make it, so I'll feel drawn to one path and the path will be lit. So recently I've been talking about choosing a minor. I kind of had one, but I want to change it. And I've really been like looking at all the different options and being like, oh God, like which one should I do? So yeah, just interesting. Then there was kind of, yeah, some randomy bits, which I won't go into. He said with the plane, the travel bug's already in me. And once I finish my studies and get more money, I'm going to go back overseas. And he said that this year there's some overseas to do with my family, which there so is. I'm going to England in December to see all my fam again. He said about my immune system, I need to try and boost it because I'm prone to getting ill and I've got like a lingering cold. So I need to rest up and recharge my batteries, which again has happened. I keep just getting ill over and over and over and I can't get rid of it. So I have been boosting that immune system. He said I'm gonna have a really good social life in 3 months, lots of invites to stuff. So we'll see, and that should be around the time that I meet Mr. Right, so. And then yeah, basically that's it. He kind of just said like, I'm not gonna overwhelm myself with uni. Like I have a lot coming up. I have a lot of stressful uni, a lot of work, maybe this boy, some friends, stuff, like a lot going on. And he said, you're not gonna overwhelm yourself, you're really good at balance. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So I don't know, I personally just was really excited about it. It was everything I wanted to hear, which again, I know is the point, like a lot of people say, like they just tell you what you wanna hear. But some of it's like, how could he have known that, you know what I mean? But like I said, if it makes me feel good about where I'm going and what I'm doing, then I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing. Overall, I just found it really interesting. I wanted to try something new and it was a birthday gift. Please, please, please share some of your psychic stories if you have any in the comments, or let me know if you really want to go see one, because honestly, it's cool. It's really cool. I will also try and remember to link where I went down below, because yeah, he was really cool. And if you're a Brisbane local or live in Queensland and you kind of go to Brisbane every now and then, I would definitely recommend it. So yeah, I hope you guys found this video interesting. I'm just, yeah, really excited, really buzzing about it. I'm really glad that I went. I will keep you updated as to whether it comes true and I meet this boy. I guess that's the main part of it. So thank you as always for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.